Welcome to part two of Why America Makes It So Difficult to Give to Nigeria. I wasn't done yet, because I have a lot to say about that. So as I was saying, at the end of part one, I contacted 25 predominantly African-American mega ministries. It's been about 3, maybe 4 months ago. Pretty much asking them to help out with the mission trip that we were going on. And I not heard a response from any one of them. But, you know, we're in this day and time where our people are so woke, quote unquote. We're trying to learn more about our African heritage, and we want to know more about where we come from and our legacy and our history. And our history all traces back to the continent. True. But we still want to be disconnected from our people on the continent, because you've been colonized. Even though you think that you're woke, you've been colonized. You've been bamboozled, hoodwinked into believing what they told you about people on the continent. And they made you believe that people on the continent are barbarians and beasts and scammers and can't be trusted. And you've fallen for it. By and large, our people don't want to have anything to do with Africa unless it benefits them. You're not doing anything better than the Chinese or the Russians. Those are our people. We are not supposed to go over there, huh? And take advantage of anyone? We're not supposed to teach a false gospel? Don't get me started on that. Because you know I'll go there. We are not supposed to defraud them or take from them. Hmm? Because if we, my people here, who have the resources, if we don't help them, who will? Everybody's going to the continent and taking from them. Pillaging. But won't give them jobs. Won't give them money. But you'll go and take their oil. You'll go and take their coffee. You'll go and take their diamonds. And won't give them any jobs. You won't even help them keep their electricity on, even though they paid the bill. Have you ever heard of a city, a major city, having no electricity for weeks at a time? Everybody lives off generators, even though they paid their light bill? If that happened here in America, we would be incensed. But it happens in the Calabar, in Nigeria, all the time. As a matter of fact, when I was over there, they were going on their 4th month. 4 months, y'all. Bill-paying people, not people in the bushes like you think. No. People who live in sprawling mansions, beautiful homes. Professional people having to live off generators because their electricity has been off for 4 months. And ain't nobody doing anything about it. Let alone internet. They can't be connected to the world because they barely can keep the electricity on, let alone the internet. Huh? I'm talking to my people here now. We with the resources that can help. No, you don't have to give a whole pile. But guess what? $20, $40 a month go a long way over there. I'll tell you how much it goes in just a minute. Give me a second here. 20 U.S. dollars to Naira. Naira is the currency in Nigeria. 20 U.S. dollars is 8,203 Naira. And 20, it would be cents, but we can't, I don't call them cents. So it's 8,203.20. 8,203 Naira. $20. It goes a long way there. What the average person is paying for rent over here, $1,000 will pay rent for a year in some places in Nigeria. There should be no homelessness in Nigeria. Are you kidding me? We have the resources to be a blessing to our brothers and sisters on the continent. And you don't have to be rich. You don't have to have a six-figure income. You just have to care. You just have to know that the need is there. That's why I'm here tonight, going off, ranting, whatever you want to call it, preaching. But I'm here to let you know the need is real and the need is legitimate in Nigeria. I'm Nigerian by marriage now, but I'm telling you, I've been there. And the need is real. So we need to stop. Pause. Wait a minute. What are we doing with the black dollar in America? Is the black investing the black dollar back into a country that's colonized us? Come on, let's keep it 100. Taking the black dollar and investing it in a country that systematically, consistently finds ways to oppress us, to keep us down. We think we're getting somewhere, but we're really not. Come on, let's be honest. The U.S. dollar, as we speak, the government that we're here, did this government can't pay their bills? Did y'all hear about that? So, the dollar, the U.S. dollar, while it still might mean something, but the whole world about to find out. And you know what? People already know. Because I was trying to give a U.S. dollar when I was to a panhandler in Nigeria, and they was like, no, 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 no. And the exchange store was right around the corner. All he got to do is exchange his dollar for Naira. But he said, no, no, no. Why he said, no, no, no? Because he know the dollar don't mean nothing. So we so busy trying to make a dollar, kill for a dollar, trick for a dollar, hoe for a dollar, whatever. And it don't have any value. But that dollar could, for right now, bless a family in Nigeria. $40 is going to send 6 young ladies to school for a year in Ebonyi State, Nigeria. $40. $40 is nothing. We spend more than that. Well, I don't spend more than that because I haven't had a pedicure in over 3 years. But y'all know a good mani and pedi cost is going to cost you way more than $40. But we don't think about these things, do we? And yeah, I'm going to go back to the African-American mega ministries. I'm going there. African-American mega ministries. Yes, there are predominantly black African-American mega ministries in this country. And instead of spending all that money on buildings, and most of y'all not even congregating to full capacity right now anyways. So you're spending all that money to pay for a building, to maintain a building, to secure a building, to pay taxes on a building, when you could be blessing our brothers and sisters on the continent. Well, Nona, why are you so passionate about missions in Nigeria? Don't you know there are very real needs here in the black community in America. Oh, yes. I'm very aware of that. Then I'm going to be honest with you. I would rather take my dollar and help my African brothers and sisters on the continent than I would here. And that's the God honest truth. Yah honest truth. I kid you not. Because to me, there's no legitimate need here. Our people are inherently selfish. And the things that we want to think are important really are not. They really are not important. And depending on where you live and where you stay, people take their money and they buy drugs. And like I said, especially here in Knoxville, Knoxville has become like, I don't want to say the drug capital, but it's, there's a lot of pill heads and meth heads here. Yeah, go get into all that. But they spending money on drugs, but they don't have no money to take care of their needs. And so they go to the ministries, they go to this and they go to that. They go to the VMC, the Volunteer Ministry Centers and all this and all of that, Salvation Armies and what have you, the charities to try to get help because they need their cash that they got in their hand to go get some weed or get some meth or get some crack. That's why I don't want to help my people here in the States. And I just see such waste. I see so much waste. There's so much. So much frivolity. You spend your money on foolish things. Yeah, it's your money. You can do what you want. But when I see, when I've seen real needs and manufactured needs, I'm going to minister to the real needs first. Before, and I might want to deal and help you with the manufacturing needs that you've made yourself. That Christmas is a manufactured need. A lot of people can't afford to do Christmas this year, but because they're, it's been tradition, people do it, and da 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 da. A lot of people going into debt. A lot of people going into debt as I speak, and they're gonna be crying next month. There's gonna be a lot of grumpy people next month. It happens every year. Every year, but what will Christ do, right? I've seen some demonic witches get real given this time of year. And do it with the camera smiling, with Santa Claus and the pictures of the gifts. Look at the little kids, they just look so happy. Oh, I feel so blessed. Because the kids got toys that they're going to break up before Valentine's Day. If they're really bad, they're going to break them up before New Year's Eve. So no, that's why I'll send my dollar to Africa. Continue to make it hard. The Most High is going to deal with you. Because that's wrong. You're wrong. You need to repent. Of your nation profiling. You've profiled a whole nation. Based upon your preconceived notions and your prejudices. And it's time to repent. Now y'all enjoy the rest of y'all Sabbath. Shabbat Shalom. And pray about what I've said. I mean, be blessed in the name of Yahushua HaMashiach.